This doesn't sound like a very difficult job, is it? I mean, who wants to go first? What was the most difficult thing so far?
Dave?
Go ahead.
Well, I'd say coordinating all the moving parts. There's the sponsorship side of it, where we're dealing with all the different brands that want to have visibility during the Super Bowl.
Okay, so just give us an example. Let's do a couple of brands.
Wonderful Pistachio.
Okay.
Aqua Hydrate. Philippe Chow. Touch and Heavenly Resorts are just a few.
Okay, and then you've got to coordinate with them, then you've got to actually put the event together.
Exactly. So about a year ago, we scouted out the location, and it turns out that we picked the right place because we're right in the mix in between the NFL experience and where some of the other events for the NFL are going on. So we're right in the middle. We have to make sure the size of the space would accommodate something like the maximum.
Well, how many square foot are you guys going to do?
14,000.
14,000 square
feet. And that's actually a downscale from previous years. Typically, maximum accommodates 4,000 people, and we're scaling it back to 1,000.
So you're going to go 1,000, 14,000 square feet. When did you start to put this all together, Mike?
About a year ago.
Wow.
And it's been a real process, from sponsorships to talent. We have Kendrick Lamar performing, so we're really excited about that. And we picked him before, you know, he's blown up after the Grammys. I mean, 7-time nominee. His performance was amazing, so we're really excited about him. Also, Patron is coming in. Traditionally, they come in as the liquor sponsor every year. And we're very happy to have them as
well.
What
kind of budgets are we talking about here?
You know, you said a million. It's actually over a million.
Over a million dollars.
Over a million dollars. And some of the setbacks that we've had is this cold weather. So in order to accommodate all the media that are going to be standing on the red carpet, we had to bring in generators, build a gigantic tent, get permits.
Where's this going to be held?
This is at a place called Espace. It's an amazing event space on 42nd Street between 11th and 12th.
I got to tell you, Dave, that really the only question that one of our producers, Brian Price, really wants to know about is, can you just give us an idea of some of the fashion models that may or may not be showing up this time?
I can tell you this. I can tell you that there are some that are rumored to come, ranging from Victoria's Secret girls to Sports Illustrated. I'm really not at liberty to say, but you guys
in the past, to give him an example, you know, just to try to give him some idea.
I would say I think that some of the ones in the past have graced their covers. I know that Kate Upton has been there. I know that
Candace
Swanpoole we had last year. Mike, do you remember a few?
Is that in the music? I mean, are these you know, fashion models and musical performers? I mean, is that that's the draw, right?
What we look like to do is kind of create a mixture of athletes, celebrities, you know, musicians.
Who was one of
models.
Your people that you wanted to have come?
I'm happy to have Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
I know that Zac Efron, Kellan Lutz. We're looking to really keep it between a young Hollywood mix with, you know, new up and coming performers and obviously all the beautiful Maxim girls.
It's really a celebration of mixing the athletes and entertainers and different celebrities.
You know, it also makes me think that, you know, you're trying to create your own stage. When do you start building this thing physically?
We started about 36 hours ago. Actual production started, but like Mike said, we've been planning
right.
for the past year.
But does this now mean, like, you know, from now until Sunday? I mean, this is an around-the-clock kind of
around
experience.
Around-the-clock experience. We start tonight at 9 and go till probably about 4 or 5 on Sunday morning.
Sunday morning is a good point because you got to wake up and actually pay attention to the game. So
that's
what do you think is
right.
going to happen?
I like Denver.
Denver.
I got to say, Denver would be my pick.
Why? Because of Peyton Manning, the quarterback?
He's got the experience. He's got the experience in this game. I think that the scale would tip to him.
You think so too, Mike?
I think so. I got to defer to Dave. Dave is an expert in sports, so I follow whatever
you
his
follow
picks
whatever
are.
What his picks are. So how many? You're expecting 1,000 people to come.
Expecting way more than 1,000. We've been spending our days turning people down, but we're expecting thousands of people to show up.
Okay.
And then only 1,000 to get in.
That's what I meant. I beg your pardon.
1,000
to get into this thing with 14,000 square feet.
Right.
What kind of electronics are going through this thing so that people can watch? And this is going to, you can watch football, you can watch anything on the screens that
you've
got there.
You'd be surprised.
How big are these screens?
You're talking about over a couple $100,000 alone that's been spent on sound and lighting.
Sound and lighting?
Sound and
lighting. Just sound and lighting.
And then we've had to get street closures for generators that have been brought in because the space can't accommodate all of the different aspects for production that we have.
Come Sunday afternoon, where are you going to be?
Hopefully alive, but I think I'll probably be horizontal watching the game.
Right, you think so? You too, Michael? Yeah.
I have some places. I'm trying to actually get to the game this year.
You're going to get to the game?
Right.
Well done.
I'm trying to get to the game. And then also, one of the things that we wanted to talk about was it's New York City-centric theme. So I don't know if you got to see the inside of some of the production elements, but we created graffiti walls. We're creating a special step and repeat. Instead of it being a red step and repeat, it's going to be a step and repeat of the city streets. And like, you know, Philippe Chow coming in, we wanted to keep the best of the best of New York City.
Well, it certainly is a celebration of New York, New Jersey, obviously the stadium, MetLife, East Rutherford, New Jersey. Obviously, you're going to be enjoying all this, but on Sunday, how fast does everybody knock all this down? Because I know that people want to get out of town as soon as the game is over.
We actually have a strike down of about 10 hours.
10 hours. So it takes you, what, 3 days?
About 3.5 days to set up, and we've got to get out quick.